Ron, we talk about stencil printing. The basic foundation is transfer efficiency. What can you tell us about it?
Well, Phil, you know about two-thirds of all end-of-line defects can be traced back to the stencil printing process. And so transfer efficiency and its consistency is an extremely important metric.
Right, and that goes back to the industry legendary study that HP did in the mid-80s.
Yep.
Mid-80s, when things were a lot simpler.
Yep.
And there they saw, you know, as you're saying, 60% defects. And you know, you and I have seen a lot worse, even when we've done process audits.
Yep. Yeah, so. Yeah, and you know, none of us can find a paper on that, but we all believe it.
Right, yeah. But we see it all the time, so it kind of works. I understand that, as I said, you and Chris Nash did some work in this area.
Yeah. Well, you know, Chris has developed a lot of stencil printing data. And he came to me and said, you know, what would be the best metric to use to analyze the data? And I suggested CPK. Mm-hmm. Because CPK is the one metric that includes being concerned about precision, the tightness of the distribution, and where the average of the distribution is. So you have one metric that gets both of those in important aspects.
Okay, so what spec do you guys use?
Typically, on the low side, 50%, on the high side, 150%.
Okay, so why CPK?
Well, again, because of the precision and right. the fact that it gets precision and average.
Okay, very good. So how did you approach this?
Well, Chris came to me and said, okay, you've given me CPK, I think it's great, but now I want to tell the difference between two, say, batches of data. I've got one that's, say, 0.95 and one that's 1.0. Mm-hmm. And of course, I think the 1.0 is better, but how can I say it's statistically significantly better?
Right, so how did you solve this problem?
Well, it was a little harder than I thought. I went back and thought about it, and fortunately, since I'm a professor at Dartmouth, I have a lot of textbooks on these topics because I teach statistics and statistical process control there. So I studied, it took me a better part of a day, and I found a textbook that actually allows one to calculate a confidence interval on CPK. So the one with 0.95, I get a confidence interval on it. It's either, you know, from like 0.9 to 0.99. And then the one that's maybe 1.0, I get a confidence interval on that. And if the confidence intervals are separated, they don't overlap, we can say with 95% confidence they're statistically significantly different.
It's very good, but that sounds like one complicated formula.
Yeah, it's not something you can look at and just get a sense for it. It's pretty complicated. But with the magic of Excel, I was able to put a formula in there. And I also developed for Chris a formula to even calculate the CPKs to begin with. So he has an Excel spreadsheet that he can do all this.
So the difference between a CPK of 95% and 100% would be pretty significant.
It's going to depend somewhat on the data size. If your data set's about 1,000, that's definitely true. Mm-hmm. But even if your difference is just like 0.99 and 1.0, mm-hmm. if your data size is large enough, that even could be statistically significant. Say it's like 30,000.
30,000?
Yeah.
We can do that now.
Yeah, well, that's one of the things about modern technology. You know, the laser scanning systems, you can make 30,000 measurements pretty quickly. So that's the kind of data sets that we have. I was just working on some recently where it was like in the 50,000 range.
Well, your work sounds like a very valuable addition to the state-of-the-art printing.
Yeah, we don't really think anybody else is doing this right now.
Very good. So where can we find more information?
You can contact me at rlasky@indium.com or go to the indium.com website.
Ron, thank you so much for sharing an excellent work.
Thank you.
Thank you.